Now screen is visible to all. Whether screen is visible? Okay. Voice is audible and screen is visible. Okay. No problem. Welcome to all of you in a first class, first lecture of non-conventional machining process in a BE Mechanical. You have completed now third year of mechanical, now in a last stage of graduation, that is a Bachelor of Engineering, that is a BE Mechanical. Welcome you all. From today, hello, am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Okay, we will discuss about the subject non-conventional machining. It is an elective subject for you. Now screen is visible.
Yes, sir, visible.
Okay. Non-conventional machining process. Myself, first of all, I introduce myself, Professor P.A. Davule, Praveen Davule. Completed my post graduation in heat power engineering, pursuing PhD from Solapur University, Solapur. Within the next month, I will complete my doctorate. I have total 16 years teaching experience. During this tenure of teaching, I have covered 8 to 9 subjects, especially non-conventional machining, industrial hydraulics, pneumatics, refrigeration air conditioning, internal combustion engine, fluid mechanics and fluid power, fluid machinery, industrial quality management, also entrepreneurship development, graphics also I have teach several times, and also basic mechanical engineering. This is my short bio data. I have published certain papers in international journals, presented some papers in the international conferences, some papers in national conferences. Also, I have attended certain staff development program or faculty development program in order to improve our teaching ability or in order to grasp what is the new trends in the market related to the mechanical engineering. Also, I have attended certain seminars and workshops, certain online courses I have completed through NTPL, right? Swayam, right? And this is my contact details. My contact number is 8412053701, and my email ID is PA Davule. Please concentrate on V, right? It may make mistake because in my surname there will be the W due to some technical difficulty. I cannot use this W in my email ID. So instead of W, there will be V. PAW@coe.seri.ac.in. This will be my institutional email ID, and this is my personal contact number, and same number is for the WhatsApp. Okay, this is all about the my small introduction. Now, we will go for the teaching or learning. Teaching and learning, it is one kind of activity, right? Only teaching, it will be some kind of a boring activity, right? So in certain cases, we will discuss certain things, or you may ask question, or I may ask a question, you may give some certain answers. So education is a journey we just have to enjoy it. That is nothing but means teaching learning. It will be a smooth activity. Learner can adapt the concept. Teacher can broadly explain that concept. That is the main thing. Okay. We have to gain the knowledge, but there will be certain background to adapt that knowledge. So this specific side, what it indicates, you must have some background of different energy sources. And what is the output you have to get? You have to get the knowledge of different machining processes. See here. If you have gone through your university syllabus, while studying this course, that is a non-conventional machining, you must have a knowledge of different machining processes. Which are the machining processes? In workshop, you may use the lathe machine. By using that lathe machine, you are carrying out straight turning, taper turning. Also, you may use the milling machine, drilling machine, and grinding machines. So, from second year, third year, you know about this all type of the machining processes. A sound background of different energy sources like thermal, electrical, mechanical, chemical is essential for successful completion of this course. Means you must have to know about the what are the different energy sources you require to perform certain kind of the machining processes. Thermal, that word, it is related with the heat energy. Electrical, it is related with the electrical energy or electrical current. It will be converted into heat. Mechanical energy means it will be related to some kind of the vibrations. It will be related to some kind of the process like erosion, friction, wear and tear. Chemical, it will be related with a certain kind of the chemical reactions that will be useful to remove the material. So while studying this non-conventional machining as a subject, student must have to have a knowledge regarding the different machining processes and different energy sources. Are you getting this point? Is it clear? Hello, I'm audible.
Yes, sir, audible. Sir, sir, okay. Students are waiting outside. Could you allow it possible?
Okay. Just a minute, we allow all. Anybody is still waiting in waiting room?
No, sir, I guess not.
Okay. I have made a setting that no one will be left outside. What is the problem? Okay, no problem. Ensure that all are in class, no one will be in waiting list, right? Okay. Why we are studying this subject? What are the course objective? What are the course outcomes? What is the need to learn such kind of the subjects? That will become under the course objective. During learning this subject, you all are expected to study various non-conventional machining process. That is the first course objective. What are the non-traditional machining processes? It is having the same meaning, non-conventional, non-traditional, both are having a same meaning. Second fourth objective, that is the students have to predict the application of these non-conventional or non-traditional machining methods in a field of engineering, where you have to use certain kinds of the machining processes. What are the specific application of all these machining processes in a field of engineering? You have to study. Use of advanced coating technology in the various fields. At the end of this subject, there will be one chapter. It will be focusing on an introductory part on advanced coating technology. It will be required in a machine coating, spray painting, right? So that will be the need of the time. So you must have to have insight on coating technology. That will be covered in third course objective. What are the course objective? First, you have to study various types of the non-conventional processing we are using. Which are those? What is the application of each non-conventional or non-traditional processes in a field of engineering? And third one, you have to focus on different advanced coating technology and where such kind of the technology are to be utilized. Means that is the main motto to study this non-conventional machining process as a subject. After studying this subject, what you are getting, it will become under the course outcome. While studying this course, this subject, students are able to classify such non-conventional machining processes. Those are utilized for a suitable material. Means, in course objective, you are studying what are the different non-conventional machining processes and what are their applications. So, by studying these processes with their application, you are easily differentiate all these non-conventional machining processes. Those are used for a particular application, for a suitable material. Select the suitable machining process for suitable materials. So you are able to select which machining process is the more suitable for a particular material. Means while machining a hard material, which non-conventional machining is superior? While machining the brittle material like glass, which kind of non-conventional machining process is suitable? As we are changing the material of the workpiece from hard material, brittle material, plastic, you may use the plastic, you may use the flexible material like rubber. So which kind of the non-conventional machining process is to be applicable for the machining of certain kinds of such materials? And last, summarize the merits and demerits, that is the advantages and disadvantages of non-traditional manufacturing process. Means, after studying this subject, you are clearly differentiate all kind of the non-conventional machining processes used for a suitable material. Also, you are able to select a particular non-conventional machining process for a particular type of the workpiece, material of the workpiece. And at the same time, you are able to listing its advantages, limitations or disadvantages, okay. So this is all about the our non-conventional machining process. Now we'll start with its structure. It is in a beam mechanical I have made changes over here. It is in the mechanical. Its code is ME315. We have to give 70 marks end semester examination, 30 marks ISE, 25 marks ICA, internal continuous assessment, and there will be external oral of 25 marks. So for this subject, you have to give an external oral, and the examiner for the oral, it is a out of university. It is not from other than our college, right? It must be out of university. If you are considering the two sections of this subject, the first chapter, it is a focus on overview of non-conventional processes. Means, what is the need of non-conventional process? First of all, what is a non-conventional process? That is very important, right? What is its need, right? And we have to give a brief review on different kinds of the non-conventional machining processes. The second chapter, it is a particular, when you are classifying these non-conventional processes, one of the criteria for the classifying such a non-conventional processes is the type of the energy we are using for performing this machining operation. If you are using the mechanical energy, then that processes come under the mechanical energy based processes. This is the second chapter. Third chapter, electrical energy based processes. Means, in first section, in first chapter, you are having a brief introduction related to the all non-conventional processes. Second chapter, it is a focus on mechanical energy based non-conventional process. Third chapter, it is electrical energy based process. In second section, also we have to study three chapters. Fourth one, that is chemical and electrochemical energy based process, where you have to study different kinds of the processes like electric discharge machining, right? Photochemical machining, electrochemical machining. Such kind of the processes you have to study under this chapter. Fifth chapter, it is a thermal energy based process, where you have to study which are the different non-conventional processes. Those are utilizing the heat in order to vaporize the material of the workpiece, or to melt the material of the workpiece in order to carry out certain kind of the manufacturing process, machining process. And sixth chapter, it is introduction to coating technology, means where you have to study what are the different metal coating processes that will be used in day-to-day life of the field of the mechanical engineering, right? This is a small overview about our this course subject, that is a non-conventional machining. If you have time, just write the name of the subject, non-conventional machining, examination scheme, IIC 70 mark, IIC 30 mark, in semester examination evaluation, continuous assessment ICA 25 mark, and this is the very important oral, external oral, that is of a 25 mark. Is it clear? Examination scheme. Hello.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Now we will discuss each and every chapter in with small details, right? You have written this exact name of the subject and examination scheme. write down the first unit, that is the overview of non-conventional process. In this chapter, we have to study what is the non-conventional machining process first. What is its need? How they are classified? Can you compare this non-conventional machining process with the conventional machining process? And we have to give brief review of all techniques. Now, as we have discussed that, we have studied turning, right? Drilling, milling, grinding, boring. These are the conventional machining processes we have used while machining a component in a workshop. What activities that will be carried out while machining a part in workshop by using the lathe or drilling or grinding machine? We must have to require the tool. Are you getting? And the material of that tool, it must be harder than the material of the workpiece. And you have to forcing that tool against that workpiece in order to remove the material from the workpiece. And the material is to be removed from the workpiece in the form of the chips. And during that machining process, some amount of heat it will be generated. And because of a generation of the heat, in a certain time, the metallurgical structure of the component, it may change. You just imagine lathe turning process. Okay. During turning operation on a workpiece, when you are carried out by using the lathe machine, first you have to fix the workpiece in a chuck, right? Then you start the machining, right? At that time, chuck is rotating along with chuck, that workpiece is rotating. Then you have mounted a single point cutting tool on a tool holder, right? And you are moving this cutting tool along the axis of the workpiece in order to remove the material from the workpiece. And we are providing certain depth of cut to that tool so that material is to be removed from that cylindrical workpiece. Where you must require cutting tool, the material of the cutting tool, it must be harder than material of the workpiece, right? Then you must have to apply a cutting force on the workpiece, means you have to give on the feed, right? Feed to the cutting tool or depth of the cut. Otherwise, material is not removed from the workpiece. You must have to give on certain depth of the cut or feed. It is also called as a cutting force. Then only material is to be removed from the workpiece. So these are the traditional processes of machining, where we require the cutting tool. There will be physical contact between cutting tool and the workpiece, right? The material of the tool, it must be a harder than material of the workpiece. If the workpiece material is a flexible one, there will be problem for the loading that material on the machine or clamping that flexible material like rubber in a chuck or clamping device. If certain irregular shape or complicated shape, if you want to machine on external and internal part of the workpiece, that is quite difficult by using the conventional machine. For that purpose, you are using non-conventional. Means to overcome the limitations of this conventional machining process. Which limitations? Conventional machining process. In conventional machining process, you must require the tool. The material of the tool, it must be harder than material of the workpiece. There must be a physical contact between tool and the workpiece. You must have to provide the cutting force or feed to the workpiece. right? And the material is to be removed in the form of chips. It may, during the machining, there will be a change in the metallurgical structure of the workpiece because of a high temperature rise during the machining process. So these are the certain limitations of the conventional machining, like drilling, like turning, like milling, grinding, boring, broaching, threading, right? So in order to overcome that limitations, we go for the non-conventional machining. In non-conventional machining, there will be no tool, right? Tool is not used. In certain cases, they may use the tool, but it is of forming shape. Means which shape you have to produce on a workpiece, that shaped tool you have to use as an electrode, right? There will be no any contact between tool and the workpiece, cutting tool and the workpiece. So this is the need of this non-conventional machining process. Now, we can classify this non-conventional machining processes based on the energy used to perform certain kind of the operations by using the non-conventional machining. Likewise, if you are using the mechanical energy in order to remove the material from the workpiece, then that machining processes, non-conventional machining processes, are called as a mechanical energy based non-conventional machining process. Which are those processes? We'll discuss in detail in next chapter, chapter number second, that is the mechanical energy based processes, where you have to study abrasive jet machining, water jet machining, abrasive and water jet machining, and ultrasonic machining. These are the certain names of the mechanical energy based system. Likewise, you have to study electrical based system, chemical energy based system, photochemical energy based system, thermal energy based system, right? And you have to compare this non-conventional machining process with conventional process. Just we'll discuss about the points. In conventional process, you require the tool, it must be harder, there will be physical contact between tool and workpiece. There will be no need of the tool in non-conventional machining, right? There will be no any contact between tool and the workpiece. And brief review of all techniques. All techniques means mechanical energy based non-conventional process, which type of the machining process are coming, that is the abrasive jet, water jet, and ultrasonic machining. In electrical energy based processes, it may contain EDM, electric discharge machining, and wire cut EDM. Fourth chapter, it is based on electrochemical and photochemical machining, right? Where you use the photochemical machining, chemical machining, right? Fifth chapter, it is a focus on thermal energy based process, where you have to study laser beam machining, electron beam machining, ion beam machining, plasma arc machining, right? Means they are related with the heat. Heat energy is utilized to remove the material from the workpiece. This is the first unit of our subject, that is a non-conventional machining. First unit name is a overview of non-conventional process, where you have to study what is the need of non-conventional machining, how they are classified, compare that non-conventional machining with the conventional machining process, and brief introduction or overview of all techniques used in a non-conventional machining. Are you getting this? Is it clear? Hello? Hello.
Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you. Now, just I mention over here brief overview of all techniques, right? Which those techniques? The second chapter. It is a mechanical energy based non-conventional process where you have to study abrasive jet machining, water jet machining. If you are compare, if you are combine some abrasive jet along with the water, then that will be abrasive water jet machining and ultrasonic machining. These are the mechanical energy based non-conventional processes. Are you getting this? In multiple choice questions, they may ask that which one is the mechanical energy based system. At that time, you must remember the name of this mechanical energy based system, that is abrasive jet machining. In short, it is called as AJM. Water jet machining is called as the water WJM. Combination of both, it is the abrasive water jet machining AWJM. And last one, that is the ultrasonic machining, that is the USM. You have to study all these processes in detail, like what are the different components, what is its working principle, what are the equipment used, which are the process parameters that will be required, what is the impact of this process parameter on material removal rate, MRR means material removal rate, variation in technique, those are used, and what is the application of these types of the mechanical energy based process for a particular material of the workpiece. Are you getting second chapter? In second chapter, you have to study all type of the mechanical energy based system, where you have to study abrasive jet, water jet, abrasive water jet, and ultrasonic machining. And all these four types, you have to study in detail its construction, working, equipment, process parameter, material removal rate, application, advantages, disadvantages. The third chapter, it is the electrical energy based non-conventional process, where you have to study electric discharge machining and wire cut electric discharge machining. These are the two examples or two type of the electrical energy based non-conventional process. In the chapter, you have to study only two processes. Those are based on electrical energy. You have to study these two techniques of non-conventional machining, where you have to study its working principle, which type of the equipment it required, which are the process parameters, how this process parameter will affect the material removal rate, what is the material for the tool or electrode, what is the concept of a tool wear, what do you mean by dielectric flushing, what is the dielectric flushing, if we are using the dielectric medium in between tool and the workpiece, and it will play a role of removing the material after machining by using the dielectric fluid. It will be called as a dielectric flushing. What is the application where this EDM machine is to be used? Which kind of a material of the workpiece where we can use the wire cut EDM process? So in third chapter, you mainly focus on electric discharge machining and wire cut electric discharge machining. And these two processes are based on electrical energy. Reading? And this is the fourth unit. It is from the second section now. Section second, unit number four, that is the chemical and electrochemical energy based non-conventional. The name itself gives its meaning, that in this chapter you have to study certain non-conventional processes which are based on chemical energy and electrochemical energy. If chemical energy is considered, you have to study chemical machine. If electrical chemical energy is required, then electrochemical machine, electrochemical grinding, photochemical machine. So these are non-conventional processes you have to study under this chapter. First one, chemical machine, CHM. Electrochemical machine, ECM. Electrochemical grinding, ECG. Photochemical machining, PCM. All these are come under the category of chemical and electrochemical energy based processes. Again, you have to study each process along with its working principle. What are the equipment are used? When you are carrying out the photochemical machining, you require the etchants, certain kinds of the mask gun. What is the technique to apply the mask gun on the workpiece? What are the different process parameters? Those are affecting the performance of the machining process. What is the MRR? Means material removal rate. What is the effect of this process parameter on material removal rate? And last, where these processes are to be used? Which kind of material will be there? Where such kind of the processes are applicable? Fifth number chapter, that is a thermal energy based non-conventional process. Thermal, that word, it is related with heat. So in this process, we are generating the heat by different means. You may use the laser beam, you may use the plasma arc, you may use the electron beam, you may use the ion beam in order to generate the heat. And by using that heat energy, thermal energy, we are vaporizing the material, or you are melting that material from the workpiece in order to remove the material from this workpiece. So in thermal energy based non-conventional process, you have to study laser beam machining process, that is in short LBM, plasma arc machining process PAM, ion beam machining IBM, and electron beam machining, EBM. In certain process, you must require the vacuum in a space where we are mounted the workpiece and you are carrying out the machining process. That is the laser beam machining or ion beam machining, you may require the vacuum. While studying all these type of the thermal energy based process, you go through the what is its working principle, which equipments are used, what is the beam control technique, what are the different parameters, what is the material removal rate, and application of these processes. And sixth number unit, that is the last chapter, that is the introduction to coating technology. In this chapter, you mainly focus on principle of coating technology. What is the coating? What is the working principle behind this coating technology? How it will be carried out? What is the mechanism of coating? There are certain types of the coating. In certain process, we may go for chemical decomposition, and in certain process, you go for the physical vapor decomposition. What are the applications of this coating technology? One more point it will be added, that is the metal spraying, metal coating, and one special technique, that is a plasma flame spraying. It is a part of a coating technology. Means in this chapter you are getting the brief review or introduction on coating technology that will be useful in automobile industry, paint and coating technology, right? So that insight it will be given through this chapter. So I repeat which chapter we have covered. First chapter, that is overview of non-conventional process. Second chapter, it is specifically for the non-conventional process which are based on mechanical energy. So that chapter name is the mechanical energy based non-conventional process. Third chapter, the non-conventional energy conventional processes based on electrical energy. So electrical energy based system. Fourth one, that is chemical and electrochemical energy based systems. Fifth one, that is thermal energy based non-conventional process. And last one, that is the introduction to coating technology. So it all about the course or subject we have to study under this semester. If you are considering it's a term work, you have to write certain assignment, out of which total you have to write 8 assignment, out of which 6, those are based on each chapter. There will be 6 chapter in subject, and there will be 2 case studies for the effect of parameter on material removal rate of non-conventional machining process. Means you may refer certain kinds of the journal papers, reputed journal papers, where you may get certain kind of the case studies while machining the hard material by using the abrasive jet machining. These are the parameters we are focusing or studying, and effect of this process parameter on material removal rate, it will be happening as like this. Means by referring certain journal papers on a web, you can write this case studies. Means for the term work, you have to write 8 assignment and 2 case studies. 6 assignment and 2 case studies. So total 8 assignment you have to submit. These are the textbooks you may use for the learning this subject. That is the advanced machining process by V.K. Jain, P.K. Mishra, likewise Ghosh, P.C. Pandey, right? These are the reference books. Manufacturing Process and System by P.F. Jaffar, Material and Processes in Manufacturing, E.P.D. Jamarov, right? These are the reference. Okay. I think it will be sufficient for today's lecture. You might have get the idea regarding the subject, that is the non-conventional machining. Samajhte ka sagalyanna? Subject kay ahe tar laksha zala? Ha, Sonali Jawan, are you getting?
Yes sir.
Okay. Non-conventional machining manje kay? Ji कन्व्हेन्शनली ज्या तुम्ही लेथ मशीन, ड्रिलिंग मशीन, राईट, मिलिंग मशीन पाहिलेत तुम्ही, ज्याच्यामध्ये वर्कपीस आणि टूल यांचा कॉन्टॅक्ट यायचा, आणि वर्कपीसचं मटेरियल हे हार्ड लागायचं नेहमी, हार्ड असलं पाहिजे, सॉरी टूलचं मटेरियल हे हार्ड असलं पाहिजे वर्कपीसच्या मटेरियलपेक्षा, तर वर्कपीस मधून मटेरियल आपण रिमूव्ह करू शकतो. हे त्याचे लिमिटेशन होते. कॉम्प्लिकेटेड शेप्स आपण त्यांनी तयार करू शकत नव्हतो किंवा मटेरियल रिमूव्ह करू शकत नव्हतो. म्हणून आपण नॉन कन्व्हेन्शनल मशीनिंग मध्ये आहोत. अँड नॉन कन्व्हेन्शनल मशीनिंग मध्ये ह्या ज्या काय आहेत त्या क्लासिफाय केल्या आपण, एनर्जी बेस्ड, मेकॅनिकल एनर्जी, इलेक्ट्रिकल, केमिकल, राईट, लाईक थर्मल एनर्जी बेस्ड. आणि त्या मशीनिंग प्रोसेस मध्ये वेगवेगळे टाईप आहेत, जसं मेकॅनिकल मध्ये अॅब्रेसिव्ह जेट, वॉटर जेट, राईट, किंवा अल्ट्रासॉनिक मशीनिंग म्हणजे काय हे दाखवलं. फॉर एक्झाम्पल, there will be certain videos available on YouTube. You may go through certain such kind of the videos, so your concept it will be clear. Just I have given a brief insight about this subject. Thoroughly we are going through each and every point of the syllabus of each chapter, so that your concept might be very clear. Just I will show one video regarding the abrasive jet machining. This is the video. Is it visible? there will be no stool is required, right? This is an abrasive particle jet. It will cutting the material from this aluminium plate. Is it visible?
Yes, sir.
Any complicated shape that will be machined by using certain kind of the non-conventional machining process. There will be no need of the tool. Tool ची गरजच नाही पा की हाय वेलोसिटी एब्रेसिव जेट वॉटर जेट तुम्ही यूज करताय. एनी कॉम्प्लिकेटेड शेप इट विल बी नॉट पॉसिबल बाय यूजिंग द ट्रेडिशनल मशीनिंग लाइक टर्निंग ड्रिलिंग ग्राइंडिंग राइट. Small shape holes, it will be produced by using the non-conventional machining. Very close tolerance is possible. See here, त्यांच्यामध्ये गॅप किती छोटा आहे पहा. हे होल आणि ही स्लाइस इथलं मायक्रॉन्स मध्ये गॅप असते. Close tolerance material can be machined by using the non-conventional. See here, how this part is to be produced from the sheet. Ultrasonic machining. There will be one animation. How it will be work? Likewise, this you have to study different non-conventional machining processes. They are mainly utilized in a field of engineering and technology. Are you get a brief insight regarding this subject? Samajhte ka subject kaisa ho sake? Hello.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, there will be certain. You are considering abrasive jet machining.
Is it microplastic? It's a plastic.
Yeah, it is a type of the plastic. Mechanical energy.
It is an abrasive plastic process. Abrasive, built by a high velocity gas material. Abrasive material used to shape or finish a workpiece to move. Part of the workpiece being worn away by friction. The process makes use of an abrasive jet, high velocity material.
These are the abrasive particles.
Surface finished hard metallic workpieces. Similar to water jet machining. process. To understand the racist cheating process, watch this video to the end. This video will cover the following about a racist gender cheating process.
Here we are using this air compressor in order to supply the high pressure air to this mixing chamber. And in this mixing chamber, we are providing one hopper in which certain hard material particles are used. They are called as the abrasive particles. Certain pinned up particles they are using. They are mixing in this mixing chamber. At the base of the mixing chamber, we are providing vibrator. So high pressure air, it will be produced by using this air compressor. It will be cleaned by this heater. And its pressure is measured over here, and that pressure of the air, it will be supplied to this mixing chamber by using this flow control valve. When this high pressure air along with this abrasive particles both are mixing over here, and that high pressure abrasive particle along with air, it will be coming through this nozzle, where pressure energy is converted into kinetic energy. So at the end of the, or at the nozzle, we are getting, nose of the nozzle, you are getting high velocity abrasive jet particle. When this abrasive jet particle strikes on the work surface, material of the workpiece, they are removing the material from the workpiece by the action of the erosion, mechanical erosion. So material is removed from that specific area. If you are going to the animation part, so it will be by
drilling, right, and high strength can be its advantages. Used to mix the gas and abrasive particles. Air is drawn by the compressor. It pressurizes the gas to higher pressures. Air is compressed to pressures between 25 to 130
compressor
psi.
Compressor is utilized to compress the air.
After compressor, there is a filter. The function of the filter is to collect the impurities present in the atmospheric air. After filter, there is a pressure gauge.
I think this is sufficient for today's lecture, because there will be next lecture, right, for the another subject. I hope that the interest it will be more in this subject when you are going through the YouTube or when you are seeing the animations related to that process. No doubt I will clear all the concepts and give thorough knowledge regarding our subject, that is a non-conventional process. If you have any doubt, if your concept is not clear during this online lecture, right, you may ask personally or call me personally or meet me personally in order to clear the concept. So I think this is sufficient for the today's lecture. From next lecture, without wasting time, I will start with the first chapter, that is the overview of a non-conventional machining processes. Is it clear? Samajhte ka? Ka fast hota hai? Hello? Amol? Amol is there? Amol Nagne? Hello?
No, sir.